Hey guys, in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create consistent characters in Midjourney. Now, we're not going to get perfect results, but there's this one technique that works quite well most of the time. First, I'm going to go ahead and start my Midjourney prompt. And in this consistent character tutorial, I'm going to create a little fox character, multiple poses and expressions. Now, it's important to add this, and you'll see why in just a moment. Now, we're going to add children's book illustration style. Then we're going to add some generic things like simple, cute, which is descriptive of children's book illustrations, full color. And after this, you want to start getting more specific. For example, yellow shoes, yellow hat. Of course, for your character, this might be different. Yellow hooded dress, yellow clothes. Basically, you want to describe consistent clothing style for your Midjourney character here. Flat color for that illustration look. And dash dash no outline. Now, I'm going to go ahead and hit enter and see what happens here. So I generated this character, as you can see, because we used multiple expressions and multiple poses. It looks relatively consistent. Now, you want to right-click on this image and go to Copy Image option. Now, I'm going to minimize my Midjourney and open Photoshop. Now, go ahead and create a new file and paste that character here. Go to Magic Eraser tool and make sure that the background is white. Now, it's not perfect, and I don't really see this first character as a good reference, so I'm just going to delete that. Now, I think this other character below here, there's something wrong with its hat, so I deleted that as well. The point here is to isolate just the good examples. And also, I'm going to do some cleanup and delete all of these leaves that are randomly placed around my characters for some reason. Now, I'm going to press delete, and so the first thing you want to do is select one of the characters by making a selection around them. Just make sure that entire character falls into your selection and press Ctrl X to cut. Now we're going to go back to Midjourney. And here you want to paste that selection right here without creating any prompts, just the image itself. Now we're going to go back to Photoshop and do the same with the second character. Just select it and Ctrl X. And bring it back to Midjourney. Paste it here. And so the idea is to do this for each individual character here. And so I'm going to copy and paste all of them one by one. And we're going to see how this will help us to create consistent character in the next. So now I'm going to go to the first image here. And I'm going to click on it. And right click here and go to copy image address. Now I'm going to start my Midjourney prompt and paste that address here and add a space at the end. Now click on the second image, right click, copy image address, and just keep adding these URLs one by one, separated by space, directly into your Midjourney prompt. So I'm gonna go ahead and copy the third image. And I'm going to do the same for the rest of them. So I'm going to speed this up. And okay, by the end of this, I should have six of my images lined up, separated by space. Now I'm going to go back to the original prompt. And I'm going to go ahead and select this text, right click, copy. And you want to paste this right at the end of your prompt. Now, remember how we had multiple poses and expressions here? So to create a consistent character doing different things, you want to replace that with the action. So I'm going to say running here. Now I'm going to press enter and we'll see what this will generate. And we're going to get four characters that are running. One of them is in the rain, which is a great idea. And here, number one, two, and four are pretty consistent with the original character. So I'm going to go ahead and upscale 1, 2, and 4. And of course, we can also create variations here by clicking on these buttons, but I'm not going to do that in this tutorial. So I'm going to speed up the upscaling process here. And these are the characters we're going to get, which are pretty consistent with our original character. Now, of course, there are times when you might want to touch them up in Photoshop before publishing your book. For example, here the tail has a white tip on the first character, but it's solid orange on the other. But at the very basics, this is a very powerful technique for generating consistent characters in Midjourney. Remember, guys, Midjourney was never intended for creating consistent characters. In fact, the whole point is to create variations and derivatives of whatever stored in machine learning models. So this is not the only technique, but it works quite well. And also, this is not the only way to write prompts for generating consistent characters. This is just the baseline. And if you come up with a better way or a better prompt for generating the same characters in different poses, then that's great. So maybe you can post a comment and share your prompts with us, so we can share them with other makers of things.